How are you? Welcome back to Aparna's Home TV, your one-stop destination for your everyday life. In today's video, I got you some tips and tricks to make perfect, softer and juicier gulab jamuns with ready-made gulab jamun mix. But first things first, did you get a chance to subscribe to my channel? If not, please do for amazing videos available on my channel. So, in this, I know that you are expert in making gulab jamuns, but these tips and tricks will take it to next level. I hope you will include them when you are making gulab jamuns. Did you get a chance to check out other desserts or Indian sweets recipes available on my channel? If not, I will leave the link in the description box below. Please do check them out. So let's go and see what tips I share with you in this video. So let's get this video started to show how to get softer and juicier gulab jamun with the ready-made mix. I'm using Priya gulab jamun mix. I'm going to mix this in milk. That's the first step for softer jamuns. So we'll just warm it up and mix the dough. So let's mix the dough. So don't add all the milk at once. You need very little milk or water. If you don't want to add all the milk, just add few tablespoons and remaining you can use the water. Either way is fine, but this will give you more softer and juicier jamuns. So let's start mixing the dough. You don't want too much because otherwise it will sink into the oil. Yeah, that should be enough. Let's first get together all the dough and slowly keep adding the milk. It will maybe require like 3 to 4 tablespoons, that's all. Almost there. That's it. You don't want too much water. Just mix it nicely. And you don't mix the dough also too much. Just little bit and it should be fine. Yeah, it's almost there. Let me make a nice ball and I'll show you. Dough is ready. It's neither too hard nor too soft. That's how it needs to be. If you by mistake, by accident, if you add too much water, just add a bit of maida to make it harder, little bit harder. That should do the job. So that's one more tip for you. So another tip is let it rest for 5 to 10 minutes after you mix the dough so that you will get those crack free jamuns. So let it rest and meanwhile we'll get ready everything for sugar syrup. Cardamom adds nice flavor to the gulab jamun, so I'm going to add 2 cardamoms. I'll take out cardamom from the pot, crush it and then add it to my sugar syrup so that they can flavor my gulab jamun. It really adds a good flavor, guys. Don't skimp on it. Don't skip this. It will nicely flavor and it will taste really, really good. My cardamom is nicely crushed and ready to use. So let's see what else we need. And the next ingredient you shouldn't forget is some saffron. If you don't have saffron, that's totally fine. Don't add color in place of it. You don't need anything if you don't have saffron. But if you do have saffron, use it. Few strands should do good. I'll just add it to it so that I can add it to my sugar syrup when I'm making my sugar syrup. So for sugar syrup, always take a wider pan so that your all gulab jamuns should fit in a one layer. You shouldn't overlap them because if you overlap them when you are taking out, they will break. So that's how you need a bigger pan so that they can all fit in one layer. One gulab jamun packet, at least for Priya, it makes around 20 to 30. So I'm going to use this pan so that all can come in single layer. And I took 2 cups of sugar, and I will exactly take 2 cups of water. That's how you need to do this. You're not boiling till some softball stage or thread stage. We are just going to boil for 5 minutes and that's it. So we'll start the sugar syrup while we keep the oil for heating up. That's when you start your sugar syrup. Right now we'll keep everything ready so that it will get going when we need. So it's been 5 to 10 minutes since we mixed the dough, and it's ready for us to make the balls. First thing you need to do is grease your hands with ghee. Little bit, not too much. We are going to pinch out little bits of dough and then make the balls later, but right now we'll pinch out the dough. Make it smaller because they will puff up in the sugar syrup. Well, as small as you want or as big as you want, but I'm going to make it medium size. So let me pinch all this and I will show you. I have pinched everything and it's ready for us to do the balls. So we'll just grease our hands with ghee. Don't press too hard, it will crack. So press lightly and make a ball. Just like this, perfect ball. I'll make every ball and then show you. Now that the jamuns are ready, let's heat up the oil and fry it in oil. We are not going to heat up the oil too much. We want just like medium hot oil. If the oil is too hot, outside will become brown and inside won't cook. You don't want that. So if for the gulab jamuns to become perfect, you need to fry them in low to medium high heat. That's it. The heat should never cross more than medium, otherwise jamuns will fry off from outside and they will be raw in the inside. So let's fry them. Let the oil heat up and we'll fry them. While the oil is heating up, we will make our sugar syrup and get it ready. We are going to let it come to a boil and then off the stove. So sugar has all melted and it came to a rolling boil. Now we'll add our saffron and our cardamom and let it boil like maybe few seconds. That's it, and off our stove. And let's check this oil to see if it's ready for our jamuns or not. Yeah, perfect. See, reduce the heat all the way and now you can add your jamuns. They shouldn't come up immediately. That's the key to adding your jamuns. Otherwise, it will like fry from outside and not fry from inside. Just fill up and I will show you. Just keep rotating the oil and look how juicier they have, golden brown they are turning. You don't have to turn them other side. By doing this, you are ensuring that they are cooking from all the sides. That's what you are trying to do. So let them cook nicely on less than medium heat until golden brown, and we will immediately transfer them to our sugar syrup. Look how perfect golden brown they are. We are going to take them out, filter the oil, and we are going to drop them in sugar syrup. Take the remaining ones too and drop them in oil of sugar syrup. Look, my perfect jamuns are ready. How puffed up they are. I dropped these in oil just now and look at the difference. How puffed up they are. It will absorb all the syrup and become nice and juicy. I hope these tips will help you make softer and nice golden brown juicy gulab jamuns. Please do leave your feedback for me. If these tips help you, please like, comment, subscribe and share if you like my videos. Thank you so much for watching me. I will see you guys back with a new video next time.